Oh, if this isn't a sight for sore eyes, Publix trucks made their way onto Pine Island for the first time in a week. Today, the Department of Transportation and private contractors finished a temporary road to the Pine Island Bridge. Governor was on Matt Lachey this morning before the president's arrival to talk about the progress.
There's a great spirit on the island, and I think folks, you know, they just wanted to be able to stay there and be able to go about their lives like they will. You obviously can't do that effectively without this bridge.
Residents are also able to go back to their homes and start the rebuilding process. But volunteers still planning to use some boats to get supplies onto the island.
Yeah, a lot of them are going to Sanibel and Captiva as well. They have a pretty good system. They'd rather keep the roads clear for first responders and people who live on the islands. NBC2's Ashley Graham is live in Matt Lachey right now, talking to people really just trying to lend a hand.
Absolutely. And of course, having this road is going to be crucial for them. They're very excited to be able to access the island by road, as well as those residents, like you said, who are ready to get back to their homes. And it's important for the volunteers here, who we got to tag along with today, who have been trying to help for the last week.
These people were like, how am I gonna survive?
Angela Hicks lives in Fort Myers. But she and other volunteers have spent days helping people here in Pine Island. Most of those days, she's on the water.
We're rugged, all right? It's like, you know, I'm on swamp, you know, buggies, you know, going around with guys, you know, and they're heavy loading things on their thing. We're almost sinking sometimes because we're just like, let's get it on.
It's been all about neighbors helping neighbors ever since Hurricane Ian passed through.
We're the boots on the ground. We're the ones getting everything out to the people. People like Angela who are loading up boats, supplies.
Those supplies end up here in the middle of the island, and they don't stay for very long. The need is constant and growing. Ice and gas are the biggest needs on the island right now. Volunteers bring everything from water and food to horse feed to cat food and even generators.
Each time that we bring a supply, it's like out within like an hour because these people, some of them were not without food for a few days because they didn't have the contact communication because of the cell towers to even know that the food was, there was something from the military or government to get.
Crews continue to use the water to get around, but there's now another path to Pine Island. It's temporary, but Pine Island Road is back open to crews and supplies ahead of an already quick schedule.
It's our lifeline. We're stranded without it.
Volunteers hope this will allow them to serve Pine Island even better.
With the people coming together, it's just truly amazing. It truly is.
Pine Islanders are tough. We'll get through this and we'll be better than ever.
And as you saw earlier, we did see those Publix trucks earlier. We also saw fire crews, ambulances, crews working on power lines, gas lines, things like that. So lots of traffic already going into Pine Island today. And between the road and being able to get certain things back and forth on the water, there's a lot of help heading to Pine Island right now to the relief of many people who live there. I'm reporting on Pine Island Road tonight live. Ashley Graham, NBC2.